A social media stoppage. For most of us, it was just a few hours in the dark. But for small business owners or influencers who depend on social media for revenue, it might as well have been a close sign. As NBC2's Evan Dean found out, that moment of black has them figuring out other ways to reach you.
At Overtime Pizzeria and Sports Pub in Cape Coral, owner Christina Amato is, well...
busy. Busy as in, like, I need to apologize to people for not answering their emails and text messages right away.
It's why here, at a place that relies on face-to-face business, they've actually become reliant on Facebook.
For a working mom, it's the perfect advertisement because I can do it from anywhere.
Overtime has some 6,500 followers.
Do an ounce of heavy cream.
A page for their upstairs restaurant and Instagram accounts for both. All this to try to reach you.
You can reach that many people that quickly with pictures, video, information, all at their fingertips.
It's crazy to see how much of a message goes online.
Chelsea Castoria of Conrick PR works with Overtime and with businesses in more than half the states. The more time you spend on social media, the more companies will too.
It's even gone as far to where we're creating videos on TikTok for our clients.
Well, it's changed the business a lot.
Even companies like Cushman and Wakefield are now on social.
Without it, a commercial real estate brokerage firm, just like almost any other industry, would not be able to survive.
So we all know social media, especially Facebook, has become a big part of business. But what happens if it's not working right or stops working altogether? Last month, that's exactly what happened.
Why is it not loading, right?
I remember going out to post and, like, nothing working.
Check your Wi-Fi. Like, I feel like that's what everybody did first.
Finding out Instagram wasn't working too, and I was like, okay, this is super weird.
The Instagram and Facebook failure impacted nearly all of us, but those who profit off reaching us were hit the hardest.
I would say in Southwest Florida, just by my guesstimation, thousands of dollars were lost in this day.
And that's just in our area. Whether or not Overtime lost money and exactly how much is hard to say, but...
could have. If it lasts more than a day, I have no way of reaching, like I just told you, thousands of people.
If an outage happens again and lasts even longer, Amato says they would reconsider how much they rely on Facebook. They'd have to. But if you don't plan on giving up social media anytime soon, you can bet businesses won't either. Just remember, things can go offline just like that.
Your message doesn't need to be centralized to one platform.
The smartest businesses out there use a lot of different platforms.
Get your message across on a website, get it across on all the social media platforms that your audience is on, and that's the biggest thing.
Reporting for NBC2, I'm Evan Dean.